Tooth numbering system is a system of numbers or alphabets given to each tooth for easy and quick communication. In all these systems, it is important to note that they are always done in view of the dentist looking at the jaws of the patient in front. So the dentist's right is patient's left and dentist's left is patient's right. Therefore, while designating the tooth numbers, never do it on your own jaw, but imagine it on a person in front of you. Universal system was officially adopted by the American Dental Association in 1975. In this system, the jaws are not divided into quadrants. Tooth numbering starts from the last tooth in the right side of the upper jaw, continues in a clockwise manner to end at the last tooth in the right side of the lower jaw. In permanent dentition, numbers are used. One designates maxillary right third molar. The tooth numbers then proceed in a clockwise manner to end at mandibular right third molar numbered 32. In deciduous dentition, alphabets are used. A designates maxillary right second molar. Then, tooth notations proceed in a clockwise manner and end at mandibular right second molar, which is designated by the alphabet T. The universal system is very simple to understand. Numbers for permanent teeth and alphabets for deciduous teeth makes the distinction very easy. It is easy to communicate verbally as well as on the computer. The biggest disadvantage of universal system is that 32 numbers and 20 alphabets for each tooth must be memorized. This is because the system does not divide the jaw into quadrants and so does not give a graphical picture in mind. Another disadvantage is the use of English alphabets, which makes it difficult for non-English speaking populations. Zsygmondy-Palmar system is named after Adolf Zsygmondy of Hungary and Corydon Palmer of US, who developed the system independently. This system divides the jaws into four quadrants. Each quadrant is depicted by a unique L-shaped symbol. In this symbol, the vertical line depicts the midline of the jaws and the horizontal line the occlusal plane. The counting in each quadrant starts from the midline and moves posteriorly. This system remains the same in both permanent and deciduous dentition. In permanent teeth, numbers 1 to 8 are used, whereas in primary teeth, English alphabets A to E are used. This is a simple method to understand. Moreover, there is no need to memorize too many tooth numbers. Division into quadrants gives a graphical picture. That is, if a tooth number was written, the person could quickly picture the quadrant in mind and place the tooth in it. The use of alphabets in primary dentition and numbers in permanent dentition also makes the distinction very clear. The biggest disadvantage of Zsygmondy-Palmar system is that it cannot be communicated verbally or through electronic medium because of the unique L-shaped symbol. In 1970, the World Dental Federation, then known as the Fédération Dentaire Internationale, introduced the two-digit system for tooth numbering, though it is now more commonly known as the FDI system. This system is the most accepted method of tooth numbering. As the name suggests, each tooth is designated by two digits. The first digit tells us about the set and the quadrant of the tooth. In permanent dentition, numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 depict the four quadrants. Whereas in deciduous dentition, numbers 5, 6, 7, 8 depict the four quadrants. Now the second digit tells us about the position of the tooth in that particular quadrant. Numbers 1 to 8 in permanent dentition and 1 to 5 in deciduous dentition. In simple sense, it is a type of modified Zsygmondy-Palmar system where the L-shaped symbol is replaced by a number. Since the two digits denote different details of the tooth, while communicating verbally, both the digits always are spoken separately. Like the Zsygmondy-Palmar system, it gives a graphical picture in the mind as it divides the jaws into quadrants. It is simple to understand and does not require any memorization. Moreover, it can be communicated verbally and on electronic medium. also the removal of English alphabets, attempts to make this symbol truly international.